Hey guys, Angry Joe here, and I'm doing a vlog update. It's been a really long time since I've done one of these, so I'm just letting you know what's going on behind the scenes here. Obviously, July seems like a slow month. Not a whole lot of games are coming out in July. I suspect the game sales in July is going to be probably pretty down. So I've taken the opportunity to go and purchase some games that I didn't get an opportunity to review, and hopefully will have an opportunity to review. I got The Amazing Spider-Man, which of course is a sequel to the movie that just came out. So I could talk a little bit about the movie and this game. Hopefully it is a good movie license game. And a few of you have said that it's not extremely terrible like some of the other movie license games I've been doing recently. And next I've got Max Payne 3. Now I've heard a lot of good things about this one. I was surprised to see that it's actually two discs. And it's got a single player and multiplayer component, which I hear is pretty good. So I'm excited about Max Payne 3, which supposedly is a little bit of a surprise of 2012. So we'll try to do reviews for these in the month of July when there's not a whole lot of games coming out. And I just wanted to show you, this just came out today, my latest addiction. I just got a box of Magic the Gathering 2013 core set. So a bunch of boosters are in here. I don't know how many booster packs are in here, but I've been playing Magic recently over the past two expansions, and then I bought a few cards, you know, from Walmart and all these other different places. I got like a ninja deck. I got all sorts of cool decks. But obviously this is the latest one, so I'm excited to open this up and play with my friends. And then what I really want to talk to you about is Bloodow, Game of Thrones. Now, if you don't know what Game of Thrones is, it is a badass TV series on HBO. And I highly, highly recommend it. But that's what I wanted to talk to you about. This series is badass. Please go out and watch the series, support the series. The season one DVD is out there right now. It's like $33 at Walmart. You know, so you could probably find it for $50, you know, locally. But that's Walmart online is $33. So go out and support this series because it's really awesome. I mean, if you look up on the IMDb ratings, this series has... it's got like a 9.5. Do you realize how hard it is to get rated that highly on IMDb? It's critically acclaimed. My friends Joe and Jacob turned me on in the series. Now for a while there, I didn't want to watch it. For a while, I was like, I don't care. It seems kind of boring. You know, at first it didn't seem like it was Lord of the Rings where there was lots of battles and lots of special effects and stuff like that. But that's just because this is actually based on a book series and there are 7 books total and it's just ramping up. It is a lot more character based. And it gets you really excited because each character is really interesting. There's lots of backstabbing, of betrayal, and the storyline has you engaged the whole way through. So I wanted to let you guys know, if you haven't seen Game of Thrones, go out and see it. Trust me, you will not be disappointed. I even pulled up HBO Go here. You could, if you don't want to buy the DVDs, you can watch them all online at HBO. Go.com. Of course, you need a subscription, but here's what you do. A lot of cable providers, if you call them up, they'll give HBO to you for free for like 6 months as a trial period. So I know Time Warner does that. I know DirecTV does it. A bunch of cable service providers do it. So call them up and say, hey, do you guys run a promotion for HBO? I'm thinking about getting it. Could I get HBO for free for a few months to try it out? Do it. Then get on HBO Go. Watch all the seasons. There's 20 episodes. Each episode is an hour long. So do that and watch. However, so I got really excited. I got all into it. I watched season one, season two, bought season one DVD. Can't wait for season two. However, when I get really excited about something, I like to do a lot of research. So I went in and I looked up, okay, so is he close? You know, is R.R. Martin close to finishing the series? And it turns out only 5 books are written. And remember, there's 7 in a series. And so there's still two more books. He's working on one right now. And the problem is the guy takes a really, really long time to write the books. But anyway, I wanted to talk to you a little bit about, can Game of Thrones continue on HBO, on television? Is this series gonna be canceled? And the only reason why I say that is because after I started watching, I got so excited, I did a lot of research, I looked into the books, I haven't read them all or anything like that. But this series is about to explode. The fantasy elements are gonna be ramped up to the max. There are dragons in it right now, baby dragons, but these dragons grow up, okay? This is all taking place on Westeros, right? The continent, it's a continent that all these houses are on and fighting on, but the story expands to outside of Westeros. All sorts of stuff happens all over the place. So it's gonna cost a shitload for HBO to continue this series. And I'm thinking, did they just get themselves into something they can't finish? So I'm worried about it, because the first season costs, set HBO back $60 million, right? And then the second season cost them $70 million. And that's about $6.5 million an hour of on-screen footage for the series. But it is so worth it because it's really, really good. But like I said, the fantasy elements are about to ramp up and it's about to get really expensive. So let's talk about, are they gonna be able to continue it? Because how does HBO make their money back from Game of Thrones? Well, number one, DVD sales. So go out and buy it. I looked up the numbers here and HBO sold, let's see, 840,000 copies on DVD. This is old numbers, so it may be more than that. So that made them $30 million on the first season on DVD sales alone, okay? And they made half their money back on DVD sales already. Now, that's not really the primary way they make their money. It's a very good way of making money, DVD sales after the fact. But primary way, obviously, is subscriptions. So if you get a subscription to HBO, obviously you're paying monthly for that and it goes into making their shows and their costs and all sorts of stuff like that. But even better is syndication. Now, I had to look this up. Syndication, for example, A&E shelled out $2.5 million per episode for edited versions of The Sopranos. So syndication, basically HBO selling the rights to the seasons to other cable companies here in the States. For rights to re-air the episodes. And Game of Thrones, conservative estimates puts it at $3 million an episode. So if it costs $6.5 million right now for an episode, you're gonna make the other half of the money back just by syndicating it to one cable company. And that's just the US. Remember, they can syndicate this all out throughout the world, okay, internationally, and make their money back. So I'm not too concerned about the cost. However, when you factor in the fact that these elements get ramped up, okay, and book three, Storm of Swords, shit is about to hit the fan, and HBO is gonna need to take that $70 million that they spent on season two and ramp it up to like 80 or 90 million. So it's gonna get pretty expensive. So that is my concern number one. What do you guys think? Do you guys think HBO can eat this cost easily, syndicate it, and make up for it? Do you think cost will end up canceling Game of Thrones? I don't think so. I think more likely, it's two other reasons. Game of Thrones is about to get really complex, and like I said, in the story. In fact, two of the books take place concurrently around at the same time. So it might be that HBO wants to, combine these two books, abridge them, and make them a single season. I don't know. We'll see. But the complications come in the fact that they've already announced that season three, which is coming next year, April, I think, of 2013, is only going to be the first half of A Storm of Swords. And season four will be the second half of Storm of Swords. So obviously there's going to be more seasons of Game of Thrones than there are books. Now, there are seven books in the series that Martin is writing. Five of them have already been written. He's working on the other two. And that leads me to the second problem, or the third problem really, is Martin takes so freaking long to finish these books. Now, I think I wrote it down here. The gap between Storm and Feast was 5 years. Feast and Dance, which is the latest one, is 6 years. So it takes them forever to write these novels. And if you think about it, the guy's 63 years old. So hopefully his health holds up and he can finish these series. He likes to take his time. He likes to say, I like to work on other projects while I write this series. But it's really important he gets it done because it's awesome. And I want it to be from the original writer. Because some people have said, oh, well, he's given his story outlines to people and they know generally how to finish it, but not all the details. Martin has not put in all the details, so I want it to be by the original writer. Need to get his ass to work. I'm sure he gets harassed on a daily basis about finishing his books, but that's the price you pay when you start a badass series like this. So, though there's a lot of variables and possibilities that HBO might not be able to finish a Game of Thrones or might have to finish it on their own. So right now it's following the books closely, but there are differences and the differences are interesting for people who have read the books. People say the books are really good, but in this case, a lot of people saying so is the series, because it's really awesome to see it on screen. It takes a few liberties here and there, and it's a really, really good series. Like I said, IMDb 9.5. You realize how hard it is to get 9.5 on IMDb? It's really hard. So I recommend this series. Go out and buy a season one. Check out all the episodes online. So leave a comment. Let me know, what do you think of Game of Thrones? Do you like it as much as I do? Do you think HBO can finish it? I mean, you know, estimate how much it's gonna cost them overall if we're talking about probably 8 seasons at least of the show, possibly 10 seasons if the books get pretty lengthy, because they said the books are gonna be probably about 1,500 pages a piece for the last two books. So, you know, possibly 10 seasons of this running at like $80-90 million a season. It's like basically like movies. That's the best way to describe it. Each episode is like a movie, so it's gonna get pretty expensive. But hopefully HBO can pull it off. You give me your thoughts, you tell me who your favorite characters are, but don't spoil anything for anybody that hasn't seen the series. Try to keep it spoiler free. But I just wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about Game of Thrones. Check it out. Until then, I'll see you guys on the next Angry Joe Show.